day would be your last, or that I'd have to say goodbye to you so fast. I'm so numb I can't feel anymore. I'm praying you just walk back through that door and tell me that I was only dreaming. You're not really gone as long as I believe. There will be another angel around the throne tonight. Love lives on inside of me, and I will hold on tight. It's not my place to question, only God knows why. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight. Made my troubles feel so small, and you were always there to catch me when I'd fall. In a world where heroes come and go, well, God just took the only one I know. So I'll hold you as close as I can, longing for the day when I see your face again. But until then, God must need another angel around the throne tonight. Your love lives on inside of me, and I will hold on tight. It's not my place to question, only God knows why. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight, singing hallelujah.
There's a time that I remember. And I wanna feel like December when somebody said me. Cause I can't reach out to call you, but I know I will one day. Hey. Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday. Everything will be alright. Who is a glass and say, hey.
Toast to the ones that we lost on the way, cause the dreams bring back our memories.
Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories. And the memories, bring back your. There's a time that I remember when I did not know no pain. When I believed in forever, everything would stay the same. Now my heart feels like December when somebody say your name. Cause I can't reach out to call you, but I know I will one day, yeah. Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday, yeah, yeah. But everything gon' be alright, gonna raise a glass and say,
anymore. Oh Lord, you know I have no friend. do. The angels beckon me, heavens open over, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore.
Right, that's one up. even as we go through this time of grief, we are reminded that life is a cycle. There's joy, there's sadness, but it's the in-between that matters. We often say that our loved ones have gone too soon, but we must always cherish the time that we would have spent with them. Years will pass and you will remember something and you will smile and your heart will leap with joy. And that's what being human is about. The moments that we have, we must treasure them. We must make the most of them. Our program will be a bit different in the sense that you all will see hymns on the paper, but songs on the PowerPoint, so you are free to stand and sing when we play the songs. Alright, we'll now have our scripture reading. Those of you who have your Bible, you can follow with me. And it's taken from 2 Corinthians chapter 5. We read verses 1, 6 and 8. 2 Corinthians chapter 5. We read verses 1, 6 and 8. And it says, "For we know that if the earthly house of our tabernacle be dissolved, we have a building from God, a house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. Being therefore always of good courage, and knowing that whilst we are at home in the body, we are absent from the Lord, for we walk by faith and not by sight. We are of good courage, I say, and are willing rather to be absent from the body and to be at home with the Lord." And it is our today that Katrina isn't here with us, that she is with the Lord. We all believe that there is somewhere better for us. We work, we labor in our lives to accomplish things. But every one of us knows that death is something that we will have to face. No one knows when that time will come. And it's often we hear people speak of regrets that we didn't do something. So I say to you today, let's not live lives filled with regrets, but instead live lives filled with joy and love. At this time, we'll have the eulogy done by Dana and Siobhan.
Katrina's best friend for the past 18 years. Katrina was a bright, vibrant woman who grew up right here in Vancouver. She lived almost all her life here with her late parents, Marla and Rudolph. If I had to stand here, we'll be here forever. Katrina was the most kind-hearted, caring, forgiving, and of course, the most friendliest person I have ever known. She was a well-rounded person who had so many dreams and accomplishments ahead. Katrina enjoyed life to the fullest. She She was the light and life of anything and anywhere. Her presence was. Katrina loved her family. Her granny meant the world to her. Granny know that she loved you very much. Don't talk about her babies, Pablo and Zina. One thing I admire about Katrina was her ability to enjoy life and live in the moment. She lived and explored this world as she loves to travel. Katrina traveled as far as Japan. Could you imagine that? At her young age, how many accomplishments she achieved. And there was so much ahead. Today I want to say to you, Katrina, I will miss you and love you forever. I want you to know that you broke so many hearts. You will be dearly missed by your husband, family, and friends. Until we meet again, I love you.
Use anybody. Ever since, that smile, her teeth, her beauty. I always call her my goddess. She was so tall and pretty. I call her my dolly. I call her goddess. She was always fun to be around. Her last birthday in December, I took her out for dinner. Dana and I. And I'll tell Brian this. I told her, I said, Katrina, allow me to say this. I'm happy hubby are here away working. But I'm glad that we get to spend time with you. And we had so much fun, so much laughter. She was happy. For my birthday in January, she was there with me. A young, vibrant, beautiful person. She brought so much joy. She was a joy to be around. She was like my pet. A grown woman, double my height, so full of love and compassion and kindness. The philosophy. Positivity only, no negative vibes. You will never know when something bothering her. You know, she'll smile. She'll try to cheer you up, to uplift your spirit. That is Katrina Dundas. I pray that the Lord Jesus will hug her so tight for everything that she represented on this earth and her quick life. Katrina is not somebody I could ever forget until I got from the school. I pray and I ask that God will open heaven and his angels will rest heavily and surround the family, Ryan, Granny, Anderson, her mom's family, her dad's family. And to lessen their confusion, we cannot question the Father. She belonged to him. We all do. And I pray just as she was a trailblazer on this earth, as she ascended and she trailblazed towards God. No devil in hell, no filth touched as she ascended to her maker. Katrina put something on Facebook the week before she died. I thank God for the life that she had lived and all her experiences, telling the world that she had made peace with her Father in heaven before she had this surgery. So smart, so intelligent, spiritual, I have to say, to guide everybody up to this point, even while she was alive. I give God praise and I give him thanks and glory and honor for her life. We would miss her. We weep like Jesus wept. The Lord understands. Mourning isn't going to last. Joy will come. Granny, I pray that keep you. Lift you up. In the mighty name of Jesus, our Lord, I give you thanks, praise, and glory. Thank you.
Thank Dina and Siobhan for that wonderful tribute to their dear friend Katrina. It's not easy saying goodbye, but it gives us the opportunity to say, even though the person is not here, how much we love them and how much we appreciate all that they would have done for us, how much they would have impacted our lives. At this time, we would leave the floor open for anyone who would like to pay any tributes to Katrina. You all can come up and say what it is you wish.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
My name is Rhonda. Yes.
I was the husband of Katrina, and then that's.
And what can I say about Katrina? There's none that I can say up here, so that I could explain what Katrina meant. My wife and I start our life from none. We work together and we try our best to be good people. The person that you guys see today in front of you is a project of my wife. She has taken me and she has molded me out to become the man that I am today. She has always had my back. She has always been there for me. I have met my wife close to 6 years now, and we have been married for 5 years and a half. I've never leave my wife's side. Never, ever leave my wife's side. The only time that I leave my wife's side to go on a business trip, treat me as normal. He said, B, go ahead, everything will be cool. I got this. I'm the boss lady now. We talk every day. We fight every day. We argue every day. One thing we never do, we never went to bed angry at each other. And our last days, she told me all kinds of things to break my heart. But I did not realize that she was not understanding to see me coming back home to you. She was full of life, and she loved everyone. Our grandmother was our world. Everyone could always see that. When I met my wife, her family was our priority. I would just like to say that I would miss Katrina so much. She is my whole world. My whole world. She gone. And just leave me alone. I stand every single night by myself at one spot without moving. Just waiting to see if she can come back. But I know that she's not gonna come back. If anyone knows me the last 6 years, they know Katrina. I've always been two peas in a pod. No matter what, we never go against each other for nobody. I was away when I heard the news about my wife.
And they tell me that I came from them.
I asked God for strength. I used every single power network that I have to cross the seas and the mountains to reach home. When I leave the airport, me and my wife was kissing and playing. When I reached back to the airport, my wife was gone. I came and see my wife in a fridge. She didn't even look like she was dead. I cried since Sunday to now. I cried. I don't know. I just feel like I'm in a really, really bad movie. And after this bad dream, I'm going to just wake up and everything will be okay. See, I love my son like if it was our own. The reason that he's not here today is because his heart has been broken more than once from our mom, our dad, and now her. I was just love to see that everything that my wife asked me to do for her is be done the right way. And she lived this day peacefully, quiet, loving, most kindest person, most retarded person that I know. Love every single human being. She has broken so much her heart. And she has even reached out and trained her as a businesswoman. Everyone know today. I live in Chiguanas and I talk to no one. Yesterday when I was coming home from Chiguanas, every single person in my street stopped me. No one didn't stop me because of me. They stopped me because of my wife. She's the person who would come out in the morning and just waving it with them. Good morning, good afternoon. How are you guys? And yesterday I saw something that broke my heart. I was leaving home and it had this one guy living in the street. I don't know, like he probably take drugs or something when he was young. So he stopped me, he said, sir, accept my condolences. He said before, me and Katrina used to talk and Katrina used to tell me, you know, straighten out your life, be back to normal, God will show you a way. And he said because of the beauty of Katrina, that he know that she used to come outside every morning at 6 o'clock and drink her coffee and she have a neighbor on the next side and she just shout, "Nibs!" And he used to wait in Katrina just to see her face. The garbage shop man, that's how far Katrina touched. The garbage shop man wait for me just to tell me that he gonna miss Katrina because garbage shop has come 5 o'clock. So Katrina decide wait till the garbage truck man and then argue with him until he came from fishy garbage 5 o'clock, he got them 6. She was just special in every single way. Every single thing she do, she was just special. I would like to thank everyone for taking time out to come to show the respect and everything to my wife. I know she'll be gone. She'll be missed by a lot. She'll be missed by me. And there's nothing else I could say. It is me in front of this stage doing all of this stuff. I was never a person that could even do this. Me going out to funeral home and picking out casket and looking at dead and touching, I could have never done that. That was Katrina. She know how to do this kind of stuff, but if she's not here, I know that she would want me to not to say nothing stupid, not to do anything stupid. She would always teach me to control myself. She'd take me, and she just taught me how to do stuff. And today I would just like to send my wife off in the right way. And anybody else who want to say anything good about her, they come up, they say anything good, because that was her request. And just know that she wrote me a letter, a message, and she told me that she was not going to die, because if she died, she would break a lot of people's heart. And she died, and she just gone. And she not coming home. I pray and I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for guidance, for mercy, for forgiveness. When I found my wife died Sunday, I pray, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Sunday night, Monday, Tuesday, to bring her back alive. Just make she fall into a coma and wake back up before she does her autopsy. I pray. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always said that you take the things that we love the most. And the only thing in this world that I love, the only thing in this whole world that I love more than anything was my wife. Anyone who know me, my wife, together. From the day that we met. When we met, we, as I said, we had nothing. Our wedding rings was barely $600 or $700. We slept on the floor. So she wasn't with me because for nothing, because we had nothing. She was just with me because she loved me. And for her, somebody as pretty and as beautiful as she to love somebody like me, and then to just go on. I blame no one for my wife then. God know best, and God know what they are doing. And I just hope that wherever she is, she just enjoy it and rock it. And I hope that I fulfill every single wish for her. The only thing left for us to bring is our dogs, but they will be at the cemetery to see her. And that's it. Thank you guys.
No more pain, no more mourning, no more sorrow, no more paying of bills, no more sickness, no going to the doctor, no hearing my nagging mouth, or Ryan nagging mouth, or Dana nagging mouth, no more illness. That is something to be joyful for. Isn't that an amen? Amen. Come on, I want to hear that amen. Amen. Any one of you who know Katrina would know that Katrina is a person full of love. Amen? Amen. My name is Peter Kumabach. I'm the person in community relation in charge of Vancouver, Freeport, Brasso. I know Katrina since 2008. We met a strange way. I just finished work and I saw three beautiful women right over the station. And well, one of them my eyes captured, that was her mom. However, Katrina gave me hell, real hell. At one point in time, I swear I was going to be arrested. As the years gone by, I started to know the family closer. I heard some of you say some nice thing, never see Katrina vex. I saw Katrina Vex. Katrina mom and her. Gangster me. Corner me. Choke me here. Slap me. But at one point in time, I was this close to calling the police. And I realized what I did was wrong. I can't tell you all it. However, Katrina was really suffering. Really suffering. Katrina talked to me every single day. She told me, she said, 3 years ago, mom died, the 6th of November, 2018. She said, I'll never forget that day. She said, 3/4 of my heart was burnt when on that day. And every day, Katrina cried. At one point, she wanted to join her parents. But because of the love and support that she had, she held on. Her grandmother, her best friends, Ryan, cousin Navin, I'm not seeing Navin here. Katrina wanted peace, family unity. All the family who are here. We are not perfect. We have our ups and downs. But one thing that she wanted to ensure that all the family could have united. When her mother died, she said she was going to make it her business to ensure that all her family, my father's side and mother's side, unite. I'm looking at the attendance here. I mean, everything being equal, COVID protocol, I hope I know police and pass. But I see you. I see love. I see real love in this room. And that is something to be rejoiceful for. Say amen. As I adopted Katrina when her mom died as my daughter. So this is not a friend anymore. That's my daughter there. I'm burying. And Ryan called me and Ryan told me this is what Katrina wants and this is what Katrina wants. Ryan wanted about 200 police vehicles. I said, Ryan, could only get one. During this, especially during this Easter weekend. I said, you will get one. And I said, as much as the police have a lot of roadblocks and duties for the next 48 hours, I will make sure that I at least get at least 2 police officers. And if I can get 2, I will be here myself. Because Katrina love, and he knows that, love TTPS, and the TTPS love her. In our final days, no, 10th. Katrina called me and she said, Peter, I'm going to surgery tomorrow. I said, thanks. How are you feeling? She said, I'm frightened. But I'm leaving everything in the hands of God. I'm leaving everything in the hands of God. Even in her weakness, she still has the faith that God at her side. She came up the operation successful. However, like her mother, they don't like to see me sad. I don't like funerals. I'm in my funeral. But I always make a promise that I will be strong. I will be strong. I cried for the past 10 days. It was not 10 days, but it feels like 10 days. From Sunday to now, right? What, 7? And I understand Dana's feeling. I understand Siobhan's feeling. Most definitely, his feeling. All the relatives, Ryan. Something, she was correct when she said she don't want to die because she'll break a lot of hearts. My heart was broken on the 28th of March. So that is 4 days now, 4 days dates I will never forget in my life. The 6th of November, the 19th, that's Mother's death. The 19th of December, 2019, that's my father's death. The 3rd of June last year, one of my batch who saved my life, death, and this death. However, we all must die. We suffer the same fate. We suffer the same fate. To me, this is something to be joyous because she has no more suffering again. No more. And I stand here proud to say that Katrina lived a joyous life. Some of you don't know that Katrina was in the process of doing her psychology. She had one more year again to finish. Anything Katrina touched turned diamond. She was the manager of Hilton. And during the off period, Hilton always make a bus. And now I know what we're talking about. We didn't bust it, but during that period, Hilton make one of the most profitable for that 5 year period when she was a manager. I don't know about now. Guardian, very successful. Anything Katrina tell herself that she's going to accomplish, she accomplishes. Some of us, as was once alluded by Dana, go to Japan. Anybody ever went to Tokopita? Right in Trinidad. Anybody have been there? No. But she has been to Japan. That's something to be joyous for. Joyous about. Katrina's life was, well, it was short. She will never be forgotten. And I asked God to carry her with her mother and father, because that's who she loved most dearly after her dogs. So, Katrina, thank you so much for that 13 years that I spent with you. It was 13 of the best years of my life, and I really mean it. And one day we will meet, but not yet. One day we will meet, but not yet. Thank you.
Hard to deal with our grief. At this time, we thank Ryan and Mr. Kamabach for sharing with us. It wasn't easy, I know. But before we had books and we had all this technology, the way we shared information was through stories. We would talk to each other. And this morning, this afternoon, you would have heard how much Katrina would have accomplished, how many lives she would have touched. You would have heard the wonderful person that she was. So we'll just take about 2 more minutes or if there are anyone else, you can come up and say what you want.
Good day to everyone. My name is Jason. A lot of you know me. For those who don't know me, I'm Katrina's first cousin and oldest cousin on her father's side. I just want to say condolences to Ryan, because for a young man, this is not an easy thing to go through. But from what he has said, came from humble beginnings. With the help of his wife Katrina, he has built himself up, and he has a lot to be proud of. It is an accomplishment in itself to be a married man and all of us could hear in his words and see in his expression that he is very proud. But with that feeling of pride will be a lot of sadness and unhappiness at this time. And I just want to tell him that he's still part of the family, even though Katrina is gone, his mother-in-law is gone, his father-in-law is gone. I say those things because even though it's a time of bereavement, it is something to note that this young man is very strong. He's very strong. My cousin was a very beautiful girl. She touched a lot of lives. She did some great things. And all we could do is remember her for the good that she did and the joy that she brought in our hearts. That's all I want to say. Because I know how many are feeling today, and I don't want to pull at the heartstrings too much to cause any more pain and grief. All we could do now is remember Katrina. Right? And we have a lot of good memories that will live with us. And when we meet up, as our lives continue, we will remember her, we will talk about her, and we will laugh about her. And we will still have some joy in the memories, even though she's not here. And it wouldn't be the same, but we still have some joy. So, for everybody who is here, thanks for coming. And Ryan, be strong, my brother.
Last call. Would anyone could say your last goodbye? I know it's hard.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Susan Gomez-Gohal, and Ryan and Kathy are my neighbors in Longville. They moved to our home, our area, just about four years ago, Ryan. Right. And the audience is our other neighbor who lives completely opposite Ryan, Sonia. And the neighbor behind Ryan lives next to me. When they first came into the area, we didn't know them. You know, as Ryan said, he never used to talk to anybody. But Kathy is so friendly, extremely friendly. And she will, you know, when they're driving out, she will always wave to all of us. And then, well, in our area, there are a lot of East Indians, and we usually celebrate Diwali, even I do it. And I remember there was the driver who they had before. He used to come and park next to my garage. And I said, I always see this lady sitting on the rooftop. Can I offer her on Diwali a dozen dinars? Because I usually fast. And he said, yes, take it for her. So the night of Diwali, I took a dozen dinars to her home. And I said, would you please accept this? And she said, Nave, I'm so happy that you came. Because she never, you know, talked to anybody. But Ryan was serious, but she would weave. We just weaved to her. And from there, our friendship began. And my house, as I said, is like obliquely opposite them, so I have cameras. I'm always looking out for Kathy and Ryan. I know all the vehicles. I could tell you what time they come home because the gate flashes on, the light flashes on my camera. So, you know, she became very, very friendly to us. And last year, the parrot, a big macaw, accidentally came off the cage. He used to walk all on the wall, and he came into my coconut tree behind. So the workers were there, and I said, hey, the parrot, get away, come on. Everybody flew, run over. The parrot flew from one end to the next, so the whole neighborhood. Kathy go in the dark, and she said, lend me the flashlight, and I gave her. She looking for him with a long stick. Kathy can't see. She said, neighbor, you go watch for the parrot for me. I said, yes, neighbor, I'll watch for it. And I look whole night, I have the camera focusing for Rio. We can't find Rio. Next morning, she got up. I said, Kathy, the rain falling. I get up, jump off the bed. And I go, and I said, Kathy, take the umbrella. She go and look in all the background. Eventually, Rio get gone. He never came back. Kathy's cried. And she said, oh, gosh, Rio gone. I said, Kathy, be strong, because I have a parrot, too. And they always make a whole set of noise. From there, you know, our relationship go over and over, you know, continue. And then when Ryan had to go on his business trip last year, Kathy was alone. So I said, but Kathy, I'm not seeing Ryan. She said, he's away. I said, don't worry, I go be your eye. I watch him for you. And every day I look out for Kathy. Every day I call. She always texts me, Nabe, you know, I really like you. And last year we had a big Diwali celebration and Kathy sponsored it. But she couldn't come outside because of the dogs and the people were all these firecrackers stuff and it was irritating the dogs. And she couldn't come out. She said, but name I videotape you. And she sent a few minutes. So she was on top of the roof and she just waved him. And before she went for the surgery, she said, name, I'm going for the surgery. I said, what are you going to do? Then she told me what it is. I said, I'll pray for you. And every day when she came out, she called me like 2 days after, name, I'm fine. And then when she started telling me all of the complications, I said, keep praying. God will look after you, you know? And then on Wednesday, she texts. I said, I don't like that text, you know. And then Friday I called her. She said, Name, I'm coming home on Friday to see you. So I said, no, come Sunday. And then when I saw the van in front of the house, I was so excited. I said, God, Kathy, come in. So when the workers came and said, come, we have something to do. I said, please don't come and tell me anything sad. They tell me, I just break down. You know, I couldn't care. And every day from now, where the house is, my camera is focused on the house. So there's no tutors. I see Kathy, ask my neighbor. He said, Nabe, you cry whole day. Whole day I cry for Kathy. Every morning after that, I keep looking. Every morning I look for her because I see her when she come out. And she opened the gate. So, you know, Kathy and Ryan, I'll be looking out for you. You know, I know you wouldn't be there all the time. But rest assured, our neighbors will look after your home. You know, call us anytime. And Kathy touched all of us. She's such a joy. She's so bright. She's so beautiful. And then she always talked about Granny. And I had recently to meet, I think, the guy down there. We had a couple of drinks in the restaurant. And he said, come up to and meet Granny. We always want to meet Granny. We never meet Granny. And Granny, you have a beautiful grandchild. You know, she's the same age as my eldest son. You know, and I said, girl, you like my daughter. You know, and she's so bright. You know, I don't know. I don't know how I'm going to live seeing. I'm not seeing Kathy coming out that gate every day. You know, she come out with the BM. I think she flash the light, come up the street, neighbor going out. So I know when she going and she coming in. You know, so Granny, Kathy isn't gone. She's just resting. And she loves you so, so much, as Brian said. After those dogs, Pablo and Zina, whew, they are alive. So on behalf of my husband and I and my neighbors, please accept my condolences.
Thank you. As we continue, if there's no one else, we'll stand and we'll sing at this time one of our hymns on our sheet. And we'll sing, What a Friend I Have in Jesus. We have in Jesus.
Sometimes when we are alone, there's only Jesus that carries us through this time.
Good evening, everyone. My deepest condolences to Ryan, to Granny, and to my family. And as everyone said, Kathy was a very loving person, always happy and bubbly. I don't think I ever see Katrina angry, but I give God thanks and praise for the life that she had, the life that she led, and for all the people that she touched. The name of this song is Be Still, My Soul. Lord, bear with me if I can't get through it.
Be still, my soul.
thank Angelique for a wonderful song. At this time we'll have our pastor, Pastor Shahid Mohammed, will come on.
Thank you very much, Pastor Aaron. Thank you all for sharing all those wonderful words and joy and love. I am Pastor Mohammed. I am one of Katrina's uncle, for you all to know. When you look at this, the photos, all the pictures, and I'm on this scene, you see all the smile of Katrina. We hear a lot of beautiful things, and it's true. She is a wonderful, was a wonderful young woman, always laughing, always smiling. When she do come up Vancouver, she look at us and say, "Uncle, how are you going?" I'll say, "I'm going good." I thank God for that. Today is a sad day, but yet is a joyful day to give God thanks and praise. One of the scripture verse I look at today is John 3:16. For the Bible said, "For God so loved the world that he gave, he sent his son, his only son, that whoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life." The King James Version says, "Whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life." He did not say a Christian, he did not say a Hindu or a Muslim, but he said, "Whosoever believeth in him shall not perish but have everlasting life." The story is about a man named Lazarus, who was dear friend of Jesus. In John chapter 11, we read that Jesus and his disciples heard that Lazarus, who lived in a town called Bethany, was very sick. Jesus loved Lazarus and his sisters, Mary and Martha. And after 2 days, Jesus told his disciples, "Lazarus has died." And that happened so that you and I may believe. By the time Jesus arrived at Bethany, Lazarus had been dead and in the tomb 4 days. There's a song that says that no matter how late Jesus comes, he's always on time. It's hard for some of us to understand that. Lazarus' sister, Martha, ran out to meet Jesus. Jesus said to her, "I am the resurrection, the life. Whoever believeth in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And everyone who lives and believeth in me shall never die." "Do you believe this?" she said to him, "Yes, Lord, I believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, who is come into the world." Then Lazarus' other sister Mary came out to meet Jesus. Now when Mary came to where Jesus was and saw him, she fell at his feet, saying to him, "Lord, if you have been here, my brother would not have died." When Jesus saw her weeping, he was deeply moved in the spirit and greatly troubled. And he said, "Where have you laid him?" They said to him, "Lord, come and see." Jesus wept. So he's going to cry. Jesus cried. Ryan, don't be afraid to cry, brother. So the Jews said, see how he loved him? Just like today, yeah, people come here to see what's going on. No, no, no. Just as the Jews. But this is what she wanted. This is what she wanted. And this is what the husband has done. He kept her promise. And it's a good thing to plan your death. It's a good thing. When you die, you want it to do this way and that way. A lot of people have plans for when they die, how they want their funeral to be. But I am one person. I make no plan. I told my wife, whenever I die, surprise me. It sounds like a little joke to somebody, but how will I know? So, Ryan, you have done what your wife requests, and thank God you have done that. But again, there are people around who want to see. You preach, you talk about this many times, and as you go outside, you hear negative thoughts, negative words from other people about the funeral. But this is what she wanted. And we should accept what she wants. So these Jews said that, look how we love him. Some of them said, he opened the eyes of the blind man. Could he have not kept this man from dying? He could. But the purpose of this, then Jesus, deeply moved again, came to the tomb and said, take away the stone. Then Jesus prayed to his Father and cried out with a loud voice, Lazarus, come out. Then the man who had died came out. His hands and his feet were bound with linen, and his face wrapped with a cloth. Then Jesus said to them, unbind him and let him go. The story of Lazarus reminds us we need not to take time, we need to take some time to grieve. Sometimes we convince ourselves that we need to do what we need to do is to be strong and press on for those around us to see how strong we are. But when Jesus came to Bethany to comfort the family of Lazarus, he did not brace himself and hold back. He cried. Tears began to flow. When we love someone very dearly, as Jesus loved Lazarus, it is natural to cry. It is natural to cry. It is part of God's plan that we go through this grieving process where we experience loss. We may not lose a loved one, but we lost many things in life. The Bible says there is a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance. Holding back the tears does not mean that we are strong. No, it means that we are weak. We are scared to accept how we feel. Some people never allow themselves to grieve. And it only hurts them in the long run. It is okay to cry. It is important to grieve. It is good to remember the precious time we have spent with loved ones. Even though it hurts, we must always remember those good times we have together. When Jesus saw the tomb of Lazarus, he faced what has happened. He likely reflect on the memories he had shared with Lazarus when he reset at the dinner table and laughed and enjoyed one another while enjoying Martha's famous home-cooked meals. The neighbor talk about the goodness and the love for each other. That is how it's supposed to be when we live with our neighbors, you know. Look out for each other. We have to look out for each other because you see what is happening throughout the world. Not only in our country, but throughout the world. They're coming without any mask or anything like that. And attacking us. So look out for one another. You have many memories with your Katrina. And they are very precious. Take time to remember them. Take time to grieve. It is okay to cry. Remember that Jesus wept. He cried. Secondly, the story of Lazarus reminds us that Jesus understands our grief. We may not understand each other's grief, but Jesus understands ours. In the darkest time, we sometimes feel like God is far away and does not understand how you and I feel. Hebrews 4:15 confirmed that God can sympathize with our weaknesses because He came to earth and lived as a man named Jesus. He endured the worst kind of suffering you and I ever suffer in this life. From grief over his lost friend Lazarus to a painful death on the cross. Whatever we are going through, Jesus really does understand what you and I are going through in life. The book of Psalm reassures us that when we pray to God, He hears us. I love the Lord because He has heard my voice and my plea for mercy. Because He inclined His ear to me. Therefore, I will call on Him as long as I live. Thirdly, the story of Lazarus reminded us that God has a purpose. Both Mary and Martha said to Jesus, "If you have been here, Lord, you would have healed Lazarus from the sicknesses and prevent him from dying." So, why did Jesus came earlier and heal Lazarus? Jesus explained the reason to his disciples. Lazarus becomes sick and died for the glory of God. So that the Son of God may be glorified through it. For your sake, I am glad that I was not there, so that you may believe. God saw the bigger picture. The eternal destiny of Lazarus' family and the crowd that gathered for the funeral were at stake. When you and I experience tragedy, we often ask why. Why me, Lord? Why it have to happen to me? Romans 8:28 said to us, "Behold, the precious promises. We know that all things work together for good for those who love the Lord." Amen? And those who are called according to His purpose. If you love God, you can be confident that He will take the worst possible circumstances and use them to accomplish something good in your life. If you do not love God, you can come to know Him today. In the case of Lazarus, God's purpose was to show that Jesus is the Son of God, so people would believe and be saved from that sin. Whatever sin you are going through, you could be saved. Finally, the story of Lazarus reminds us that Jesus is Lord of life and death. Jesus proved to everyone that he was truly God by the incredible miracle raising Lazarus from the dead. He did a lot of other miracles, but this one was very important. Now you might think, Katrina will not be risen from the dead. You might think so. But the Bible tells us that someday everyone will be risen from the dead. Everyone. And will have to stand before God to give account for what you and I have done here on this earth. Every one of us. Not only the Christians, you know. Every person will have to do that. Jesus said to Martha, "I am the resurrection and the life. Everyone who lives and believeth in me shall never die." Receive the Lord of life. The Bible teaches us that we all have sinned. All. We have all disobeyed God's law. We have all ignored God and lived our own way in our own terms and conditions. We all do that. Romans 3:23 said that the wages of sin is still death. It didn't change. It's still death. But the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. That a change. That remains the same. But God is a very loving. He's a loving God. He showed his love for us in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. He died for the ungodly. He didn't die for the Christian. He died for every one of us. Many people, they say that Jesus is for the Christian. No, it's for everybody. He's for every one of us. We are children of God, supposed to be happy. Jesus died for us. He went on the cross for us. He paid that penalty for us. Things that we couldn't do for ourselves, He had done it for us. The wonderful news is that Jesus did not stay there. On the third day, He rose again. Just as Lazarus, God raised him from the dead. Today, Jesus is at the right hand of God the Father in heaven, praying for us. He wants all of us to be reunited with Him. Someday, come about say not today, but someday we will be united with Him. He's not willing that any should perish. You know. He expects that we all confess our sin and turn away from our sin and look to Him as our daily hope for salvation. Romans 10:9 promises that if we confess with our mouth, open your mouth and talk that Jesus Christ is Lord and believe in your heart that Jesus raised him from the, God raised him from the dead, you and I will be saved. Although death is a solemn reminder, it also points us to the most wonderful, hopeful promise or message, as you may say it. Jesus is Lord of life and death. Whoever believeth in him will not perish, but have eternal life. May God bless you as we continue with the funeral service.
Thank our pastor for his message. Reminds us that this life we live is just a part of our journey. And even though if we know Jesus, death is just a part where we must pass through. It's not the end. We think of it as a new beginning. Would have heard a lot as it pertains to Katrina and the life she would have lived. And one of the things that would have stood out is her beauty. Most people would first notice that. But the book of Ecclesiastes says that beauty is a fleeting thing. As we get older, we know how true this is. For the men, the hair is loose. They lose the hair, not as thick. You see, lines on our foreheads, all these different things. But as we heard today, many may have noticed Katrina because of her beauty, physical beauty. But her true beauty was the way she would have touched each and every life. And that is the mark of someone touched by God. Someone who God loves, someone who God has had a part to play. As we continue, we'll sing our last hymn. I can only imagine it will be on the screen. We can all sing while we follow.
Thank you.
this time I'd ask you all if we all would stand as we close in prayer before. Heavenly Father, Lord, we honor your name today. We praise you. We thank you, Lord, for the cycle of life. Even as we mourn today, Lord, we acknowledge your goodness and love beyond everything for us. We pray at this time for Ryan, for Katrina's grandmother, for her cousins, for her family, Lord, that you, oh Lord, would pour out your mercy upon them, your grace, dear Father. Help them as they go through this difficult time, that you would strengthen them, dear Lord, that even when all have left them and they have that quiet time, Lord, they will know that they are not alone. As family, as a community, as friends, as well-wishers, dear Lord, we pray that we continue to support them, that we encourage them, that sometimes we just stand next to them and be quiet, dear Lord. We know, Lord, that nothing can replace her in our lives, but we thank you, Lord, at this time for all the good memories that we have of her. Help us, Lord, that she may never fade in our memory, that the love she shared with each and every one of us will never fail or be forgotten. As we leave this place, dear Lord, to say our final goodbye, we thank you, God, that you have allowed us to spend this time with her, that you have allowed us to enjoy her impact on all of us. And we just pray, Lord, for the family, Lord, that you would be there with them through everything. We thank you, Lord, for all that we were able to do today. And we ask God that as she rests with you, we can only imagine how happy she is at this time, dear Father. She may have left us, but we know, Lord, that she is with you. And we pray, Lord, that you would take good care of her, that you, Lord, would help her, Lord, to truly rest at this time. We just pray and ask these things in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. As we would proceed to view the body, right, I would ask that in an orderly manner that we would come to the front, we would view, and we may exit. We would all exit through the door to my right, and you all could pass to the side of the church and back out front. I thank you all again for being here.
I'm missing. Yeah. through the door. But I don't know if you have seen the fire, right? The two men come, so John and I will be outside there waiting for the assembly, right?
Didn't know today would be your last, or that I'd have to say goodbye to you so fast. I'm so numb I can't feel anymore. I'm praying you'd just walk back through that door and tell me that I was only dreaming. You're not really gone as long as I believe. There will be another angel around the throne tonight. Your love lives on inside of me, and I will hold on tight. Not my place to question, only God knows why. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight. Always made my troubles feel so small, and you were always there to catch me when I'd fall. In a world where heroes come and go, well, God just took the only one I know. So I'll hold you as close as I can, longing for the day when I see your face again. But until then, God must need another angel around the throne tonight. Your love lives on inside of me, and I will hold on tight. It's not my place to question, only God knows why. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight, singing hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight. Didn't know today would be our last, or that I'd have to say goodbye to you so fast. I'm so numb I can't feel anymore. I'm praying you just walk back to that door. Thank you. didn't know today would be your last. But I'd have to say goodbye to you so fast. I'm so numb, I can't feel anymore. I'm praying you just walk back through that door and tell me that I was only dreaming. You're not really gone as long as I believe. There will be another angel around the throne tonight. Love lives on inside of me, and I will hold on tight. It's not my place to question, only God knows why. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight. Always made my troubles feel so small. And you were always there to catch me when I fall. In a world where heroes come and go, where God just took the only one I know. So I'll hold you as close as I can, longing for the day when I see your face again. But until then, God must need another angel around the throne tonight. Your love lives on. Didn't know today would be your last, that I'd have to say goodbye to you so fast. I'm so numb, I can't feel anymore. Praying you just walk back through that and tell me that I was only dreaming. You're not really gone as long as I believe. There will be another angel around the throne tonight. Your love lives on inside of me, and I will hold on tight. It's not my place.
Yeah,
hurry up now. We're waiting and hurry up now. Beautiful song in the sweet by and by. We shall meet on the beautiful shore. We shall sing the beautiful shore. Melody and song of the blessed, and the spirit shall sorrow no more. Not a sign for the blessings of rest. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. To a bountiful Father above,
I'm so numb I can't feel anymore. Praying you just walk back through the tell me that I was only dreaming. You're not really gone as long as I believe. There will be other angels around the home tonight.
How so long I can't feel anymore.
Attention, everyone. Now this is a saying, brethren. Taking out the music. Yeah. No, not yet. The music. Yeah, you could cover it. Your turn. Now this is a saying, brethren, the flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God, neither do corruption inherit incorruption. Behold, I tell you a mystery. We all shall not sleep, but we shall be all changed in a moment, in a twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall rise incorruptible, and we shall be changed, for this corruptible must put on incorruptible, and this immortal must put on immortality. But when this corruptible shall have put on incorruptible, and this mortal shall put on immortality, then shall it come to pass the saying that is written, dead is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is your victory? O death, where is your sting? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God who give us the victory through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Wherefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the works of the Lord, for as much as you know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. My friends, whereas death has once more invaded our ranks and moved from the walk of life, our beloved sister Katrina, whose soul have departed to dwell in the of her soul, having departed to dwell, to bond, to travel with no return. Just a minute. It had become sad duty to commit her body to the grave, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. Inspiring privilege to redeem the soul of her Maker, Father, according and again to the confident hope of the coming again. Our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the resurrection of the body from the grave, and the joyful life restored for the children of the light in the realm of glory. May the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall guard your heart and your mind through Christ Jesus. for the glory. To our Father be glory forever and ever. Amen. Good. Nico, continue. Let's sing this song.
Jesus is mine, oh what a fortress of glory divine, heir of salvation, which is of God, born of His Spirit, washing the This is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Soul is at rest, I in my Savior, I'm happy and blessed, watching and waiting, looking above, filled with His goodness, lost in His love.
This is my story, this is my song.
This is my story, this is my song,
praising
my Savior all the day long. All right, people are going to step back a little bit and let the earth mechanic and do the work now. Thank you.
tonight. Your love lives on inside of me, and I will hold on tight. It's not my place to question, only God knows why. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight. Always made my troubles feel so small, and you were always there to catch me when I'd fall. In a world where heroes come and go, well, God just took the only one I know. So I'll hold you as close as I can, longing for the day when I see your face again. But until then, God must need another angel around the throne tonight. Your love lives on inside of me, and I will hold on tight. It's not my place to question, only God knows why. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight, singing hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Jealous of the angels around the throne tonight. Didn't know today would be our last, or that I'd have to say goodbye to you so fast. I'm so numb I can't feel anymore. I'm praying you'd just walk back through that door and tell me that I was only dreaming. You're not really gone as long as I believe. There will be another angel around the throne tonight. Your love lives on inside of me, and I will hold on tight. It's not my place to question, only God knows why. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight. Always made my troubles feel so small, and you were always there to catch me when I'd fall. In a world where heroes come and go. Well, God just took the only one I know. Thank you.
Take a small one out. 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 Take a small one out.